prevented from acting on an issue you bring to his attention until the matter is agenda for discussion at a future public meeting. You're limited to 2 minutes per speaker. The first speaker I have is Lisa Almeida.
I think stepping up and participating in the community. But I want to say that the college of process that's going on tonight, I'm very familiar with the bylaws, I've memorized and read them at least twice, is you need to fill the vacancy. Under Article 5, Section 6, filling the vacancy and our recent city, you guys should have your bylaws before you're aware of them. If the director resigns, is expelled, or is recalled from his or her position, or if there are not enough candidates to fill a specific category during the election, the board can nominate individuals to fill those vacant positions, and all candidates must verify the stakeholder's status by completing the application, and the order of selection is as follows. You use the same category, you use the top runners up of the same category, then you nominate from the stakeholders, and then the board will decide on them. But remember, you guys have to, if there are not enough candidates to still fill a specific category during the election. And I know the rules. There's three vacancies in the South region. So at the next executive meeting, expect agreements on my first stakeholder initiative. Thank you.
Thank you. evening, everyone. Congratulations on your election. I also want to congratulate those that served on the former board. I know we have a couple individuals here. Congratulations for your work. Again, congratulations to those that have recently elected. Our office is here and open to be able to work with all of you to make sure that we work on projects that are meant to the community. Okay, so I want to go over a couple of items. Let's see, on Sunday, May 18th, we have a South Huntington Drive community cleanup. It's on a Sunday. We'll be meeting at 9 a.m. at Fire Station 47. And the focus of this will be clean up bulky items all of South Huntington Drive, starting from the fire station all the way to the bridge. May 18th. We have flyers in the back if you choose to take one. And this will be in conjunction with on that CPAP, our town of Sereno, Bago Action, Green, Green, of course, Fire Station 47, and Fogo Tap, and we hope to that LA32 can join us for this event. Let's see, and a couple of updates. Budget. Currently, City Council is reviewing the budget for the next fiscal year. Hearings began last week. They have continued this week. And after that, there will be a hearing at Council for May 20th. Council vote is expected for Wednesday, May 21st. And I will leave it as that. All right, thank you.
Okay, we have two more speaker cards, and we'll move on. Maria Miranda.
So report is pending, so just let me know so that I can either present it at the executive committee or I can present it at the board. So congratulations.
To do this
to the best of my ability.
we're going to move over that item. Item number six, the past president, Connie Castro, already alluded to the fact that she either entertained or gave a presentation at the executive or at the next general board meeting. So we're going to pass over item number six, and we're going to get into the new board orientation. For you all. Okay. So a couple of things. In the binder that you have today, first of all, I introduced a lot of those for those of you who haven't met me. I'm in the South Los Angeles area. I'm a project coordinator. I've been with the department since the inception, since 2000. I've worked in several different areas in the department as well as across the city. I support the 16 almost neighborhood councils in the South Los Angeles area, and I am a counterpart to the Fed. She's currently at another meeting tonight, so we are tag teaming across the city to make sure that at the first meeting for every neighborhood council, we're able to provide training so that everyone starts off at the same footing. It's important that you get the basic parameters in regards to running meetings, knowing your bylaws, things of that nature, so that you understand what this mechanism is called in neighborhood council. In your folder?
Yes. I was wondering if you could take a moment to review the letter that was passed out to us concerning the policy effort. There's a lot of new board members that may not understand what is also the message that we need and how it applies to the leases that the board from last year.
Okay, I can only give you a brief overview of what exhaustive efforts are. As it returns to this board, that's something that you'll have to take up with Lisette, because she's a staff person that staff on LA32, and she has the back history. She has the backstory and the history as to why it came about, what the measures are in regards to where you are in the process for mitigating the contingencies laid out in the letter. What exhaustive measures are basically a program that assists a board when it falls into, crisis, but it falls into an area where it's not functioning at the level that it needs to function based on the plan. And so with that, the department makes a determination that it needs to become the neighborhood council, then goes into receivership to the department, and the department assists the neighborhood council in a variety of capacities. So within the letter, I basically outline kind of what are the items that the board needs to fulfill. And so now that there's a new board, I'm sure there's an evaluation that will be made, but it will not be determined by myself, which is why I can't really answer specifics as to the why, the what, and the when. But it basically laid out, a plan is laid out, and once that plan is fulfilled, then the department will review it and make a determination to release you from the plan. So it's not a thing that goes on indefinitely. It's basically there's criteria that needs to be met. Once that criteria is satisfied, the department can make a determination to release you, and then you're back on your own. Typically, some of the things that we do is run your meetings, set your agenda, things of that nature to kind of help the process. We do require that you have a quorum at every one of your meetings just to show that you're up and running. But it's not so stringent, whereas the neighborhood council can't take position and work and things of those nature of pretty much why you're on the board at least, to create impact within your community. So that's basically what I can tell you at this point. Yes.
In the past, when we were in the exhaustive, the past committee was only allowed to make decisions as far as election outreach and elections 2014, and all the funds were frozen as well. Do those terms still apply currently in this, with this new board, for the exhaustive efforts now?
Until they make a determination otherwise, the answer would be probably yes. But again, that's something you'll probably have to follow up with. And so she can give you more information as to a timeline. Okay. Yes.
One more. Piggyback on what she was just speaking of, the money. This means that we could still go into this not being able to spend our money for them well into July and August, well into after the new money's in, the old money's gone, which is the last day of June. for the old money, the new money, the first day of July. We're still in hot water like we are right now. That means we probably won't be able to spend that money, even the July money.
Correct? Well, I cannot answer that question. That's something that Diego has to take up with Gracie Wu, who's the general manager of the department, and you need to speak with them on that. So I'm not here to speak on the specifics. The general manager asked me to look at the letter, which I did, and I can't really speak to the specifics. That's
so unfortunate that your name blew out.
I understand your point there. Okay, so in the folder, there's a couple of things. One, the most important thing in there is your bylaws. Your bylaws are basically your governing document. It tells you how the infrastructure of your neighborhood council works. And there's also the board member handbook, and that's the long version of the most important things that you need to understand about the neighborhood council process. So I've broken them into about 7 different areas, and we're going to go through them. For my own purposes, how many people on the board are new to the neighborhood council system altogether? Okay. All right. Well, welcome. All right. So just for your benefit, who for those that are returning, who can tell me how the neighborhood council system came about?
Way once upon a time, Mayor Reardon, Republican, excellent Republican, worked for both sides of his party. Since the San Fernando Valley has been trying to separate itself from this part of Los Angeles, the seat, I think is the word, Mayor Reardon came up with the, all this money comes out of the mayor's section. Mayor Reardon created, through his staff, created this system, and all the work that came in and been tweaked and refined over the years is what we have today. And as you alluded a moment ago, it's still being tweaked for us here.
Okay.
But that's basically the nothing and bolts that I understand.
Right, so there was an effort to see the values and see from the rest of the city. And there was a ballot that was, there was a measure that was placed on the ballot for charter reform. It happened in 1999, and that the charter was reformed and established the Department of Neighborhood Empowerment, as well as the Neighborhood Council system. The department, we do have a 7-member commission. There are policy setting commissions. They are not a day-to-day operation commission, and we have 7 for each region in the area. This is the EPEC.
This is the East Bank, Northeast LA.
I can't remember. It's not down. It's not down. Okay, so there's a 7-member commission, board of neighborhood commissioners, and you can find their bios off of EmpowerLA.org. The department runs the, Olivia Rubio. She was on the Boyle Heights, she's on the Boyle Heights. She's your commissioner for this area. And so the department says policy. We went through the charter reform in 1999. There was then an opportunity for the department to go out and touch the community to create a plan. The plan is also in your board member handbook, and it outlines what a neighborhood council should look like. It should be diverse, it should be open, it should be transparent, it should provide impact. But there's a twofold impact in the plan for the what neighborhood council should be doing. Does anyone know what that twofold mission purpose is for a neighborhood council? So increase participation and to make government more responsive to the needs, to the local needs of the community, of the people they serve. That's a twofold responsibility of you all from a neighborhood council perspective. So you see you have some of your elected official offices represented here, and that's really the goal, is to increase participation civically and to Our goal is